Dear innovators, in the last class, we realized the meaning and definitions of an extension. We understood that education is an integral part of extension service. Along with that, scope and importance of extension, along with the types of extension we have learned. With this lecture, we are going to understand objectives and principles of extension. Let's start with the objectives of an extension. Objectives defined as the expression of the ends towards which our efforts are directed. It is different with the goal. Goal is the distance in any given direction one expects to go a given period of time. Objectives consider the direction of movement, whereas goal is the distance in a given direction during given time period. Expression of the ends towards which extension works are directed are the objectives of extension program. Development of the people is the fundamental objectives of extension. In general, objectives of an extension are as follows: to assist people to discover and analyze their own problems, to develop leadership among the people, to disseminate information important for agriculture, to keep the research workers informed about farmer problems time to time. Usually, objectives can be categorized into three levels. They are fundamental objectives, general objectives, and working objectives. Fundamental objectives are very broader in terms, whereas general objectives are little specific to the fundamental objectives. But working objectives are very much specific to the subject matter. Working objectives consider audience, content, and required change very specifically. Fundamental objectives of an extension is development of the people, providing them with good life, better citizenship, and democracy, etc. To achieve that, general objectives of an extension can be helping rural people to have better home living. To have that, to improve farmers' knowledge on cut flowers, to improve farmers' knowledge on vegetable cultivation, to improve farmers' knowledge on dairy production, to improve farmers' knowledge on better soil nutrient management practices, etc., can be working as our working objectives. This is all about objectives of an extension program. Let's see four great principles of an extension. Extension believes individual is the supreme in democracy. Home is a fundamental unit in a civilization. Family is the first training group for the human race. And the foundation of any permanent civilization rests on the partnership of man and land. Along with the four great principles, extension work considers the following principles. Extension work must follow the principle of interest and needs, grassroots principle, principles of cultural differences, principle of cooperative and participation, principle of learning by doing, adaptability of an extension teaching methods, principle of leadership, whole family principle, principle of satisfaction. Let's see in detail. Extension work or extension program must consider interest and needs of the local people. Even we found the problematic soils in the village, but the farmers feel the improved varieties are their felt needs. We have to start our work from the improved varieties only. Gradually we have to deal the problematic soils in the village. Extension program should start from grassroots level. Aim of extension should be local or existing situation. Before launching or diffusing polyhouse technology to the farmers, we have to analyze the farmers' knowledge on precision farming. If they need any training or skill in precision farming, we have to attempt that first. Our extension work must be suitable to the culture of the farmers. For example, a demonstration on mushroom recipes should not be conducted in a village where mushrooms eating is a sin. Extension work must allow the participation and cooperation from the local people. Anna Hazare's Rally Ground Siddhi is the best example for people's participation and cooperation. Learning by doing involves maximum number of senses. Hence, allow the farmers learn the things by doing them. Various methods of teaching we need to use. while teaching the farmers based on the situation and learner's background. Extension work must be involved local leadership. With the local people only, our program will be successful. Extension work must involve all family members, youth, women especially, along with the farmers. Principle of satisfaction. Unless the people are satisfied with the end product of any program, it is a failure. Farmers don't adopt anything unless they satisfy with the end product. So, we realize what are objectives, what are the objectives of an extension, what are the levels of an objectives. Along with that, four great principles of extension and various principles of an extension while doing extension work. Thank you.